Hello friends, I am Rohan Sogule. Today we are going to study the basic concept of list. List is one of the basic data structure available in Python programming. So before starting with the list, we'll discuss the basic concepts related to the list. So here, one of the most data structure available in Python programming is the sequence. So in sequence, the element are written in sequential format, and that element has one unique ID, and that ID is nothing but we can call it as a index number. So here index number is always start with the zero. That we already know that as we have studied the concept of array. So here basically six built-in type data types of sequence available in Python programming, but most commonly we study the list and tuples. Okay, so here today we'll discuss on the basic concept of the list. Okay, so what is list? So the list is one of the most versatile data type which is available in Python programming. So in the list, whatever elements are there, that elements are written and each element is separated with the help of comma, and these elements are written in the square bracket. Okay, so elements are separated by the comma and are written in the square bracket. So we'll see examples so you'll easily understood the list. So here one of the most important thing related to list is that whatever elements or the values in the list are there, that values or elements in the list need not to be of same data type. So we can write different data type elements with the different data types in list. Okay, but we have to make sure that we have to separate them with the help of commas and are written in the square bracket. Okay, so here we have an example, that is list one. So here if we see list one, so this is the name of list. We can write different name for the list. So for our sake of convenience, I have written the list one, the name of the list. Okay, so list one, it contains the elements 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 5 integer type elements are there, and each element, if you see, each element are separated with the help of commas, and elements are enclosed in square bracket. Okay, as I said, indexing is given for each element. So 1 is at 0th index, 2 is at first index, 3 is at second index, and so on. So indexing is always start with 0. Okay, so this is another example where I have written the ABC. Again, same, they are separated with the comma and enclosed within a square bracket. So next, as we know that whatever elements are there need not to be of same data type. So here I have written the elements of different data types. So 1, 2, then India I have written, then A I have written. So characters, string, integer are mixed over here. So here in the last example, I have written the elements 1, 2, A, B, 7.8, 8.9. So here I have written the elements of different data types. So this is a simple way to write the list or to declare the list. So hope you understood how to declare the list. So now how we are going to access the elements. Now suppose I have to print the list, or I have to print the elements from the list. So how I am going to print, let's see over here. Okay, so here let's see, it is a simple thing to print the elements from the list. So let's see, here I have written one simple example list. This is again name of the list. As I have said, we can write different name for the list. Okay, so list having elements A, B, 1, 2, 3.4 and India. Okay, again I have written the indexing for each element and are enclosed in a square bracket. So how I am going to print this list? Simple, we have to write the print function, and in square bracket we have to write the name of the list which we have to print. So print list, what it will print? It will print the elements of the list as it is. Okay, in square, it will print in square bracket only. So in square bracket it will print A, B, 1, 2, 3.4 and India. Whatever elements we have written, it will print as it is. Okay, now suppose I want to print specific element. Okay, for example, here I have to print the value of a, sorry, value at 0th index. First value I have to print. So how am I going to print? Print in round bracket, I have to mention the list name, and again in square bracket, I have to mention the index. So here this particular statement will print value or element at 0th index. So at 0th index we have a, so output we get a. What if I write 1 over here, then it will print b. If I write 4 list, if I write 4 over here, it will print value at 4th index, that is 3.4. okay, so this way we can print particular value from the list. Now next, suppose I want to print in multiple elements from the list. So how I am going to print that? Again, same, print in round bracket we have to mention the name of the list, that is list over here. Then in square bracket we have to print the starting point from where we have to start printing the elements, and this is a boundary. Okay, so in this case it will print the element at first index, that is it will print first b, then it will move towards second index, and it will print up to fourth index. Phi u is a boundary line, so it will print elements from first index to fourth index, that is from b to 3.4. so it will print b 1 2 and 3.4. so here the output b 1 2 and 3.4. so this is a output we get after execution of this statement. Now suppose if I have not mentioned the boundary line, so here is the example. Yes, I have just written the starting point and I have not mentioned the end point. So what it will print? It will print from first index to the last index. So here last index is 5, so it will print from 1 to elements from index 1 to index 5, that is b 1 2 3.4 and India. So here is the output, it will print b 1 2 3.4 and India. So in this way we can print the elements. So here I have mention the ones another example. As I said, the indexing start with the 0, 1 and so on. Okay, so here I have written the example num equal to 20, 30, 40, 50. Four elements I have written. And if we see here, I have mentioned the positive index and here I have mentioned the negative index. So negative indexing concept is also there in Python programming. So here last element is, it has the index -1, second last -2 and so on. Okay, so if I print 1, as usual it will print value at first index, it will print 30. If I print 3, if I write 3, it will print element at third index, that is 50. If I print num -1, so it will print the element at -1 index. So as I mentioned, negative indexing start from last element to the first element. So -1, it will print 50. -4, it will print -4, it will print 20. Okay, so again negative indexing concept is also there in Python programming. Okay, so next we'll start with the concept of updation. Now suppose we know how to write the elements, how to print the elements, now how to update the elements. So how we are going to update the elements? So simple, just look at the example so you will easily understand the concept. So basically here I have written one simple example, num is equals to, this is the name of the list, which is equals to 20, 30, 40 and 50. Total here we have 4 elements. Okay, again indexing start with the 0 to 3. Okay, now suppose if I print the value at index 2, num 2, so what is value at index 2? It is 40. So it will print after execution of this statement. Okay, value at index, after execution of this statement, it will print value at index 2 is 40. Okay, Then what we have written? Num of 2. This is the index number. Num of 2 is equals to 99. So here what we are doing, we are assigning value 99 to the index 2. So it will update 99 at index 2. So it will remove 40 and it will write 99 instead of 40. So if I print after updation of this list, if I print after updating value at index 2 is equals to num 2. So what it will print now, instead of printing 40, it will print 99, because here we have updated the list. Okay, so similarly we can update the 0th index, 1st index, 3rd index, and so on. Here we have updated the 2nd index. Okay, so this is easy concept. So next we'll see the how we are going to delete the element from list. Okay, so basically to delete or to remove the element from the list, we have two different concepts. First one is del statement, okay, and second one is remove method. Okay, so today for this point we are going to study the del concept only. In next point we'll study the, or in the next part we study the remove concept. Okay, so how we are going to use this del statement? So here we have syntax, just we have to write the del keyword, then name of the list, and we have to simply mention the square bracket, and in that square bracket we have to mention the, or we have to write the index number which is to be deleted. Okay, so just see the example. So this is simple syntax: del list name, and in square bracket we have to write the index. So what it will do, it will remove the element at that index. Okay, so here just see the example. I have written the list by the name num, having 4 elements and are separated with the help of commas. The 4 elements are 20, 30, 40 and 50. So each element is separated with the help of comma and written in the square bracket. So if I print num, what it will print? It will print the elements of num, that is 20, 30, 40 and 50. Now what next? I have written with the help of this syntax del, I have written as it is name, list name. Here we have num, so num, and in square bracket we have to write the index number, that is 2. So here this particular statement will delete the element which is present at index 2. So which element is present at index 2? So 20, as we know, indexing always start with 0. So at 0th index we have 20, at 1st index we have 30, at 2nd index we have 40. So this del num2 statement will delete the element at 2nd index, that is 40. So after execution of this, we have, what we have written? We have written print after deleting index 2, and we have written the statement print num. So it will print the num, that is list, as it is. So here we have removed one element, or we have deleted one element, 40. So it will print simply 20, 30 and 50. So here is the output. After execution of this statement, it will print 20, 30 and 50. Okay, so this is simple points which are related to the list. Now in the next part, we are going to study the basic list operations. Okay, so this is the first part. So we'll study next points related to the list in the part 2, that is list and its operations. Thank you.